What the heck is happening in the King County real estate market? Things are crazy. We are in the midst of a housing crisis. I'm going to go over what I am seeing today for buyers and sellers in the King County real estate market. This is also happening in Pierce County. I think it's pretty much statewide at this point. Our current housing crisis is due to extremely low inventory. I think we are at the lowest inventory levels I have seen in my 17 years of selling real estate. So why is this happening? Normally we have a backlog of houses to sell. Houses that are priced too high, they need some work, they're in a bad location. But right now we've sold out of all that inventory. All of that backlog is gone. New construction had a lag for a bit due to COVID and the shutdown. They are now starting to ramp up, but they are behind. And now lumber prices are through the roof. Permit prices have increased, and it's getting very expensive to build a home. We are seeing that you have to buy a new construction home as a pre-sale a year in advance in some cases. The time that everybody wants to sell a home because the weather is nice is between March and September. This is our peak selling season. We are seeing inventory come on the market in fairly normal amounts, but the problem is we don't have that backlog of houses anymore, which makes us very, very short on inventory. In addition, interest rates are super low. Yes, they've ticked up just a little bit, but they are extremely low compared to a normal interest rate. So we have lots of buyers out looking for homes. There's lots of demand and very little supply. Due to so little supply and such high demand, we are seeing houses sell in just days. There are many offers for the same house. They are selling way over list price. Buyers are waiving their contingencies. So no inspection contingency, no financing contingency. They're waiving appraisal contingencies. They're paying extra money in case the appraisal comes in low. Some buyers are having to tap into their 401k to get that extra money so that they can buy a house and win the multiple offer situation. If you'd like to know what all those contingencies mean, I have a video for each of them on my channel. Go check those out so you know in advance what they mean. Buyers are paying additional money in case the appraisal comes in low. That means they are paying above what an appraiser is calling market value. Buyers are even cashing out their 401ks to come up with this additional money. Now, using a 401k to buy a house is not always a bad thing. It's one investment for another. But some of them are paying penalties for that money. And that scares me. Waiving all your contingencies means you are buying a home based on a 15 to 30 minute appointment, if you can even get that, because there's so many buyer showings. Or you're paying for a pre-inspection and may not get the home. Your earnest money at this point is pretty much non-refundable. And some people are even paying the signing bonus. So in order for a buyer to compete in this market, they need to have additional money to pay towards a down payment in case the appraisal comes in low. You need to waive most of your contingencies, if not all, and you need to pay way above list price. I have seen up to 25 offers on a house, and I have seen houses sell for $100,000 to up to $200,000 above list price, depending on what the price point is. Now, if you are a seller, things are great. You most likely are going to sell your house very quickly with multiple offers and likely above list price if you have it at market value. Now, you can't just go pick a number out of the sky or a very, very high number. It still will not sell at that point. You still need to list near market value, but if you list at market value, you likely will still get higher than list price. There are some things to caution on the seller side, though. The house has to appraise for the sales price. If it doesn't appraise for the sales price and the buyer doesn't have any additional money to spend, then either you have to come down in price or you start all over from scratch. If it is a cash offer, you have no worries. So if you can find a cash offer, that is a bonus. Even if you have a buyer that pays additional money towards the down payment, if the appraisal comes in low, it's not typically the full amount of the inflated price. So they may offer to pay $10,000 more or $20,000 more, but if the appraisal comes in $30,000 low, you still have a discrepancy. This is just to caution you that there are appraisal controls out there. It is so fun to know that there are so many buyers out there wanting your home and bidding on your home. It is a bit overwhelming to review 20 different offers. It could be 20 different offers with different prices and different terms, or it could have 5 different offers that are at the highest that are all very, very similar, and you have to decide which one you're going to go with. It's not always as easy as it sounds. There's always going to be 19 very, very sad buyers. Another situation I have seen is buyers are just trying to win a house, so they're doing everything possible they can. But if they have an out in there, some sort of contingency, sometimes they get cold feet. If they get cold feet and back out, your second highest offer may not be at the high point that you accepted. You now have that expectation of the high price from the first offer. So just a side note, it is not over until it's closed and you have money in your hands. Things can happen during the sales process. I hope that sheds a little bit of light of what is happening today in the King County real estate market. Please let me know if you have any questions at all. Don't forget to watch my videos on what are the different contingencies and the cost to buy and sell a house at the same time. Thank you so much for watching.